We'll move on to the next topic called page layout. Okay, page layout is something what you are seeing here. If you look at an opportunity, you are seeing the fields here, right? Opportunity owner, private. Page layout is the one it determines which field should come as first. Again, what is the, it is now, it is looks like the two columns, right? Whether it should be looks like the two columns or three columns, or which order it should come. And if you go and check the related, what are the fields should be available in the related list, and what are the lists should be available here. These are all determined by the page layout. In order to edit or create the page layout, again, you have to go to your object manager. Go to opportunity. Page layout. So you have to choose which page layout you are in. That is something you have to check and determine. By default, these page layouts are available. If you look at here as marketing, sales, support, it is like based on the user profile. In the very first class, we see whenever you create an object or fields, you will see a profile, right? You can even assign the page layout for each profile so that it will looks like, for example, if a CEO logged in into Salesforce, it will give him a different look, give him access to different fields. If a manager logged in into the Salesforce, it will give him access to the different fields. That is something you can achieve using this page layout. Okay, let me just edit the layout which we are working on, system administrator. If you look at here, right, the fields are available here. You can just click and drag and drop. You can change the place of the fields. Suppose if you don't want these fields to display here, click on remove button. It will be removed. It will be removed and it will be available here. Suppose you want the fields, click from here, drag it and put it here. It's a very simple operation. All that you have to do is click, drag, drop for the field level. Suppose if you want to do any changes in the related list is something, the objects related to the parent object. I will come to this related list and part in detail in during the relationship topic. For now, you just understand, you can still able to edit the fields of the related list, which field should be displayed. You can remove that and you can still add a buttons and all. If you look at the buttons, you can add or remove the buttons, you can add or remove the fields, even you can add or remove the related list. If you remove that, it will disappear from the page layout. If you just go here, it's the page. Refresh it and see, you can see the reference here. Look at details. See, some field, the discount percentage, previously it was here, now it is here. And we have removed a few related lists that is not appearing here. This is how you can edit the page layout. Suppose if you want to create a new page layout, you have to go to page layout, click on new. That's it. By default, it will ask you either you are going to use an existing page layout to appear. If you don't want, right, you can click on none. If you click on existing page layout, whatever the fields available in the existing page layout, it will come. So kind of you make a clone and you will start to work on that. Otherwise, if you want to start from the scratch, you can give the scratch. I'm giving like individual layout. By default, it will have only the mandatory fields. Similarly, suppose if you want to make some field as mandatory, right? You can make here required. Actually, there are two areas. One is when you're creating a field, you can make it as a mandatory. if you make put it as mandatory in the field level, it will be available in the page layout also. You cannot remove that from here. This and all mandatory field. You cannot remove from it. You don't see the remove icon here, right? But only for here, if you add some other field, you can see the remove option. So you can either put it as mandatory in the field level, or you can still put it in the page layout level. So I created a new page layout, but something right from the sketch, no related list, nothing. It can be saved. Okay. This is how you can create a page layout and edit the page layout. Any doubts so far? Any questions?
Yeah, I have a doubt.
Yes.
So we can only one layout to a profile?
Yeah. For a profile at a time, you can have only one layout. For example, and, tell me.
And for each object as well?
Sorry?
Means if I assign a layout to a profile, okay, then it will be able to each object or different object?
See, this is for only for the opportunity. Okay. Suppose if you are going for account, right? In account, it will have some page layout. So for a profile, you can assign the page layout for each object. If you don't assign any page layout, right, it will take the default one, which is something like this.
So we can't have more than one layout for each object.
Actually, this is opportunity. In this opportunity object, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layout, right? But for a profile, out of this 5, you can assign only one.
Okay.
Okay. This is okay. Something, if it is learn to profile, you can assign one. Suppose if you want to take two or more page layout for a particular profile, right? Then you have to go for the record type. That is something I'm going to explain you now. Okay. So based on the record type, you can have the different page layout.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Any others, any questions? Okay. Okay, now we are now clear with the page layout, right? Let's move on to record type. Okay. Before go into record type, let me give you a very practical example. Okay. See, record type is something you can expect the interviewer to ask the question. This is a kind of a very mandatory question you can expect during your interviews and if you do some certification. If you are able to explain what is record type to the interviewer, right, he will be really impressed, because that will show your understanding of Salesforce and especially the configuration. Okay, let me ask you the question. Suppose you are going into a bank, any bank, to start an account for yourself. At the same time, I'm also coming, but I'm representing my organization called AJ Skill Development. I'm also coming into the same bank and I'm coming to the manager. We both going and we both are asking, we are here to create a new account or new account for us. Immediately the bank, what will they do? They will give a form to you and me as well. As an individual, they will give you the form. As an organization, they will give me the form. As an individual, you will see in that form your name, date of birth, spouse name, Aadhaar number, house address. These under the fields they will ask you to fill. But at the same time, for me, what they will do, they will ask organization name, director's name, organization PAN code number, organization address, right? The purpose is same. We both are here to create an account, a savings account for us, but we are two different entities. It means we are two different record. But the purpose is we are going to create an only account in the bank. Suppose if the bank is using Salesforce to save our data, they are using account object to save our data. But it will really confuse the bank, which is an individual account, which is an organization account, isn't it? Suppose if you're going into if I'm the Salesforce administrator for a bank, if I'm going to create a record for you as an individual and as a organization in account object, all the time going to create a click on the new button and we will start to create it. But suppose if the bank has thousands of customers or millions of customers, in order to differentiate the customers, who are all individual customers, who are the organization customers, they need something to filter out, right? That's what the record type comes into the picture. Record type is something helps the Salesforce administrator to differentiate the records in the object level. Just try to understand. If you don't understand, I will again repeat. You have an object called account. I rename it as an organization or contact. Within the object, if you want to differentiate the records, you will go for record type. So see, if I'm in the account object, I'm clicking on new. It will ask you now individual account or organization account. If you try with your account, right, it will not ask you until you create a record type for us. Actually, I have created a record type. That's why it is asking individual or account. If I choose individual, it will ask me only individual data. Suppose if I choose some other record type, right, it will ask me to fill the other data. Maybe I can show you in the contact level. If it is an organization, and if it is an individual, I show you how to do that. So similarly, in order to create a record type, go to, okay, let's do that in an opportunity level. First, we create two different fields. One is for individual, another for account. Sorry, another for organization. I'm just quickly creating two fields. Some individual text box. Okay. And I'm choosing this field should appear only in the individual layout which I have created. So I have now a layout called individual and I added the field. Now I'm creating one more layout called organization layout. Okay. So let me create one more field called organization field name. But I choose this field should appear only in the organization layout. So now I have two different layout. One is individual, another is organization. So in organization layout only this organization field will appear, and in individual layout only this individual will appear. So now I will create a record type. One is individual. It can be, okay, sales process. Since it is an opportunity, it is asking a sales process. It give you any sales process. So see, here it is asking to which profile you are giving is this access. By default, we are enabling for all the profile. Next. Then select the page layout. This is an individual, right? So I'm selecting individual. Same. So created a record type called individual. Now create a one more record type called organization.
Ashok?
Yes.
Just like a question. Can I go?
Yeah, yeah.
Can I go? What is the sales process?
Yeah, that's what I will explain to you. That is something we will cover in the during the sales cloud classes. This is something I just want to quickly show you how to create this layout and all.
Okay, that's fine.
Organization. Because if I started the sales process right, that will confuse you guys because I'm just going with the basic. Okay, now we have two page layouts and we have two record types. Okay, now if you go to your opportunities, click on new. See, previously it didn't ask which record type you're going to create. Now it is asking because we have created a record type and we have assigned the page layout. Click on next. It will ask to enter only individual details here, right? Suppose if you select an organization, it will ask you to enter organization details. So that's how you can differentiate the record types. Suppose if I'm giving org data. Suppose if you have millions of customers and you have, along with organization details, you will have many fields to enter. I'm just enter the test data field. Similarly, you can create one more field, one more record. Individual. So likewise, if you have millions of data in the individual and org data, right, you can generally people will create a filter or they will create a new list view to filter out the records. Suppose if the user, your end user, asking you to get the list of only individual data, right, you can filter it out using the record type. This is different. I'm an opportunity record type. Okay, here it is. If I put select individual, it will show me only individual record. Since we have only one record, right, it is showing. Similarly, if you have millions of record, it will show only individual. Similarly, you can add a filter for organization. So that's how this record type works. If you have millions of data, in order to filter out the data among that, you can use record type kind of thing to filter it out. This is one of the applications of record type you can still use. Okay, so that's all about today's class. So today we are just quickly go through. We have seen what is validation rule, what is formula field, what is of page layout, how to create a page layout and edit the fields in the page layout, and record type, how to create and assign the record type. Just one thing, make sure you have a clear when you are creating a record type. Okay. Make sure you have selected the all profiles. Just don't quickly click on next and next. For each step, right? You understood all the process, I mean, and all the things, and read out all the things what and all given here. Since I already know, I just quickly go. Since you're going to do that for the very first time, you just read all these things, then select. Make sure you are selecting enable for all the profile. Suppose if you missed it out in this step itself, right? It will be a quite a difficult task. You have to go through some steps, then only you can reply. So make sure you have given enable for all profile for all that. So the meeting is going to end quickly. Suppose if you have any questions, let me know. Maybe I can send you the invite again. You can join. Anybody have any questions so far?
Ashok, a quick question on this calculated field.
Yes.
Calculated fields, we can still use it for report generation and all, right?
Yes. Yes, Rajesh, we can use.
Okay. Mm. Okay. That'll be good.
And that you can use. I will share, I'll already share you all the case studies. In that case study 1 to 4, you can do case study 2 using this. Case study 2 and 3, I guess.
Okay. Okay.
Anybody have any other questions?
That's okay, I have one question.